you know, it, I can only speak for myself, really. I like being able to. I'm a very conservative director. I have a lot of ambition about my my predecessors, all the geniuses that all of us, whether we know it or not, are learning from and upon whose shoulders we stand. And so I do a lot of looking back and a lot of, you know, understanding what makes a good story, the way Hollywood used to tell good stories, starting with silent movies, when there was there were just a few subtitles to help you from time to time, where the visual arts were explosive and very direct and really led you to an emotional reaction and a huge climactic ending without any words at all. And then how when films first found their voice, they all sounded like plays until Howard Hawks decided to make everybody talk faster and throw in a couple of fantastic graphic visuals and start to use composition. So my whole love for this media comes from paying attention to the past and respecting all the movies that have been made over all of these years. And that's what I say to film students when they say, how do I get a job? And I say, well, it's easy to get a job if you write, because if they buy your script, buy enough of your scripts, you can insist on directing them, or you can just take your device and go out and make a little movie. Anybody can do that today. But I also say you need to look at the old films. You know, I used to have to pay my kids $10 to watch a black and white movie. I actually bribed them. If you watch this movie, and $10 is a lot of money when they're 12 years old. If you watch Red River with me, I'll give you $10. And I had a couple of my kids start the movie and 20 minutes later give me my $10 back and leave the room. It's not easy. It's not easy to get us all to look back. But I continue to learn, not just from the films I'm seeing today. I continue to learn from the films that were made 70, 80 years ago.